Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you want to see how I melted the crap out of this lace front wig, stay tuned. So here's how the wig came. They also included some lashes, bonus points for them. This is a 13x4 frontal wig from Gem Beauty Supply on AliExpress. It's 24 inches and 150% density. It wasn't pre-plucked or bleached, so I did have to do that myself. I realized when checking the knots that they weren't getting bleached, so I just used the brush to push the bleach into the lace a little bit more. But definitely be careful when doing this because you can go a little overboard, and I definitely overbleached in some spots, but you're not even gonna be able to tell. Hey y'all, I'm still a beginner at plucking, so don't come for me unless I sent for you. Especially since I need to be plucking a widow's peak, which is exactly what my hairline is, but I continuously pluck straight hairlines. I don't know why, but it's what happens. Now, I had a crochet style in prior to this video, which is why I have a leave out, so don't mind that. This is not like a great braid pattern, so just ignore all of that, okay? I'm going to be using the bald cap method for this install. Honestly, I could have done it without that, but I just love how seamless it ends up looking. Excuse me while I admire myself bald. You know, do you think you could see me bald or with short hair? Because I've been low-key wanting to big chop my hair, and all my friends is like, no, your head is too big. But I feel like I could work it. What y'all think? Luckily, I have some got to be gel in my travel bottle, or I would have been super upset. I'm going to be using that along with the got to be freeze spray to lay this wig down. Step in the party, you know, I got girls on my left and right. And I'm sipping under any, sipping under, cause I'm trying to get right. With a couple paintings, off black, off white. Off black, off white. I don't wanna be a blue, y'all. Hey, Jules, baby. Yeah. Stepped in looking like a painting. Y'all cannot even see where this lace starts because it blends so freaking well. Of course, when cutting your hairline, you want to make sure that you're cutting the lace in a zigzag kind of motion so that it actually mimics your real hairline. Obviously, my real hairline is not straight, but I plucked it straight. So, you know, what do I know about real hairlines? Not a thing, clearly. Used to give a fuck, now you're counting for my love. Babe, I need to get these racks up. Have a man causing injuries to get into me. Oh, it's time for the baby hairs. The baby hairs. Which I'm getting a lot better at cutting my baby hairs, in my opinion. And I'm not even a big fan of them, but I feel like this hair definitely needed some. Off block, off white. Off block, off white. I don't wanna be a blue, y'all. I'm looking for a white. We like to dance, we like to dengue, we like to bounce. We like to dance, we like to dengue, we like to bounce. I did twist his hair off camera, but I have to be honest, I didn't like how they came out, and as I've been wearing it, honestly, the twists have not been working for me. One thing I noticed was the front of the hair and the back of the hair, I think, are two different textures or lengths. There was just a distinct difference in the shape of it, like once you got to the back, like it just didn't curl up like the front of the hair did. And I ended up cutting it, but like I'm the type of person, I hate cutting hair. Like I feel like when you get it, like it's supposed to, you know, just pop it on and that's it. Like I paid for all this hair, why do I have to cut it? So it really hurt my heart to cut it, but I had to because it was so noticeable, guys. Like, I don't know what they did, but it was not cute. Every time I think of cutting my hair and then I do wigs like this, I'm like, I just can't wait for my hair to get this length. Like, maybe I should just try like a really short wig. Like, I think that might be the go-to, because if my hair can get like this, baby, talk about unstoppable, okay? I'm going in with some black powder to fill my part, just because it looks like Jesus is parting the Red Sea down my scalp. And I don't got time. To style it was really easy. I just wet the hair and put in some of my Curls Poppin' Pineapples Leave-In Conditioner. I'll say that 10 times fast. And then I detangled it with my Denman brush to really get those curls poppin'. You gotta get them poppin'. Do y'all see how juicy those curls are? Ugh. Sidebar, if you haven't already checked out my review of the Curls Poppin' Pineapple Collection for 4C hair, I'm just going to leave the link down below and somewhere on the screen, so go ahead and watch that after you finish watching this video, okay? Alright, so I've detangled all of my hair now, and I'm just going to let it air dry. I beg you, baby, kick it to the left now. If you wanna eat it, no pressure. I only do range, no Tesla. Balmain dripping umbrella. I'm tryna love you like a gangster. And this is the final look, guys. I'm gonna be honest, this next minute is just clips of me just feeling myself. Not only was my makeup on point, but my wig was on point, my outfit was on point, and I was just feeling myself, like, Now, to spice up this look, I just added some fun, cute clips to the front, and you can obviously do whatever you want to the front of it, because the front of it is looking like your scalp at this point. It's your scalp. And I'm going to leave the links to these barrettes down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like what you see, make sure you thumbs this video up. Comment down below your thoughts on this wig, and most importantly, subscribe. And make sure you hit that notification bell so you're notified when I post new videos, because 2020, we are coming with some heat. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys. I give you love, make I give it to you faster.